Hello guys, this is the first tutorial video on this channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to build a suspension system for a trophy truck like this one, allowing you to easily traverse off-road terrain, just like this. Let's start with the front suspension. Yes, that's right, my front suspension isn't symmetrical. The reason is that I wanted to achieve a longer suspension arm length in a limited space to increase suspension travel. Once you understand how this suspension system works, you can also build a symmetrical one. The movement of the front suspension is basically like this. Alright, let's begin by building a basic framework. Next, let's add these steering hinges. We'll paint the parts to make everything easier to see. I usually set the speed of the steering hinges to 2. The angle is set to the maximum. The steering help and strength are set to 0. Then, let's disable the control buttons. Next, we'll build the suspension arms, and I'll represent these types of connecting parts in brown. The lower suspension arm needs to be connected to the spring, and don't forget to also install a steering hinge at the connection point. The orange parts will be the hinges responsible for steering the wheels. The main spring is connected to the body through 2 pistons. These pistons are used to adjust the angle and height of the suspension. I've set the horizontal piston to 0.75, but you can adjust it based on the geometry that works for your vehicle. The vertical piston is set to 0.7, and this value will affect the overall height of the vehicle. One thing to note is that changing the piston's angle will also affect the stiffness of the suspension. This completes one side of the front suspension. Let's add some weight and test it out. Great, the suspension geometry looks fine. Now, we'll build the suspension on the other side using the same method. The principle of the build is exactly the same, but since it's asymmetrical, we'll need to make a few adjustments. Now we move on to the most complex part of this trophy truck, the rear suspension. The rear suspension is crucial in real-life trophy trucks, with multiple links affecting its performance. We'll do our best to replicate this suspension system in the game. The rear suspension allows for both vertical movement and rotation, like this. Next, we'll add rotational force. There we go. Since it's quite complicated, I'll leave half of the suspension for now to make the build easier. Because there are so many steering hinges with different orientations, I've used three colors to represent the three different axes of the steering hinges. Let's start with the center piston. Make sure the center bent pipe doesn't connect to the blue piston beside it. I've set the vertical piston to 0.5. And the horizontal piston to 0.75. Just like the front suspension, the piston values affect the spring angle and vehicle height. Next, we'll build the suspension arms for the rear suspension. There are two steering hinges in different directions here to connect the suspension arms. Then we connect the spring, which also requires steering hinges in two directions. The spring is connected to the piston through a hinge. Next, we'll connect the suspension arms to the rear axle. This connection will use steering hinges on three axes. Once the build is complete, we can attach the wheels. Now, while working on the inner links, let me explain the purpose of this piston. This piston will essentially control the angle of the rear axle. I'll set the piston value so that the rear axle returns to a vertical position. Alright, now we can move on to building the links. I've set this piston to 0.8. Then, we connect the piston in the other direction. Setting the value to 0.2. This ensures the link is angled. By the way, the links must be angled to resist lateral deformation in the rear suspension. Here we add two hinges, and then connect the rear axle using three-axis steering hinges. Notice there's another steering hinge between the links and the rear axle. Now let's add some weight to simulate a fully built trophy truck. Next, we set the spring parameters. Stiffness needs to be adjusted according to the vehicle's weight. I'll set the damping to 2. Let's now demonstrate how the suspension system works. To achieve the perfect suspension, tuning the spring parameters is crucial. This takes time and requires gradual adjustments. You'll likely need to tweak based on the weight, speed, and height of your vehicle to get the best performance. Lastly, thank you for watching until the end. Feel free to discuss in the comments, and I'll see you next time.